Our world is constantly changing. This content will help you get creative, have fun, learn to make money, and spread your awesome. Here's how this new economy will work for you.
Hello, everyone. I'm so excited. We have Danielle McAllister here with us today. Danielle's is a Shopify expert, an internet person. She is the knower of so many things online, and more than ever, she's going to be a great resource to talk about how you can take your business from where it is right now, the work that you're doing, and try to get it online. So welcome, Danielle.
Hi.
Hello. Also, I'm loving all the things behind you right now.
I know it looks busy, but that just means I have a lot of jobs going on. So
I love it. So let's get right into it. How, if you are thinking about going online, selling your products, what is the most important thing to get online? What is the best e-commerce platform for you? How do you know which one is the best for you?
It really does depend on what your needs are and what your comfort level with technology is, and also your budget. Because, you know, Shopify and Squarespace are both just base level to start about $30 a month US. And some of them are free. Like, you can get on Etsy for free with minimal listing fees, and all their fees come out afterwards. There's also Square, like the little point of sale that a lot of makers use. They have an online store platform as well that is no extra cost. They just take out credit card fees like they would normally. So it all really depends on your budget to start off with, because you never want to go into debt to start your business. Mm-hmm. And then it's like, can you figure out how to use it? Do you feel comfortable building your store on that platform? But start with budget first and then go from there. If you hate how something looks, then you may need to pay for a different platform that you'd like.
A different template or a different, okay. And also, I'm realizing we're recording this conversation. So people that are watching, how's it going to look? Am I a little box and you're a big box?
I don't know, actually.
When it records, I don't either. So this is the first one. This will be interesting. Okay, now this is really interesting, because people that are watching, it's like, oh my gosh, it might be so daunting to go from, you know, everything that you've been doing has been offline, you're trying to go online, and maybe the transition of going to a full, like, Shopify interface might be overwhelming, but you're seeing a lot of people going on to Instagram. That's what you're comfortable, you're already using it for your business. So how do you set up your Instagram shopping page? And what's unique about that?
So the Instagram shopping is sort of a feature you can get through e-commerce platforms, where you can add it to your account. And it seems difficult, because you have to get approved through through the back end of Shopify if you're using that. And you need to get approved by Facebook, and then again by Instagram, even though they're owned by Facebook.
Is this, you need to get permission for Instagram shopping, or mm-hmm. this, okay. So yeah. It takes longer because you have to get permission.
Yeah. Take from like 24 hours to a week, depending on how fast they can approve your products.
Okay.
Because essentially all those community guidelines that we follow when we're posting on Instagram, they have similar ones for the types of products that you can tag. So there are certain products that you just can't tag because they don't follow the community guidelines. And it has to be like a physical product. It can't be a service.
Right.
And it can't be a ticket or something that is not, like, you can't sell a gift card, for example. It has to be like a necklace or a table or something like
something physical. So I think that's going to be really right now important. And this video and this conversation is really focused around, if you have a physical product, we will do another, we'll interview someone else focusing just on, you know, what it looks like to selling your services, because I think that's where we're going to be moving. So, now the question, things are really moving and changing every day. So what you're sharing today obviously could change, but the demand for shipping is going to only increase, especially if everyone is going online and, you know, there's going to be a higher demand. That's how we're going to be getting a lot of our physical products. So if you can kind of give us some insight, what does the shipping look like? You know, what do I charge? How do you know to navigate the world of shipping? Because it's really expensive, especially in Canada. And ideally that's, you know, our audience will be in Canada, especially if it's keeping it, yeah, keeping it local. So if you can, you know, when do you offer free shipping? When do you pay for it? If you can, because I know you've been working for years around the shipping model and figuring that out. So in the best place possible, you know, can you give us some insight on the shipping models?
Yeah, so shipping is a pain in the butt for everybody to figure out. It doesn't matter if you've been doing it for years or if you started yesterday. It's always sort of a trial and error sort of deal. And you really have to look at the types of products you sell. If you sell small things that can fit in a small box, actually, I have the box. One moment.
This is perfect.
Yeah. So this is a slot box, and it actually fits. You put it in an envelope, and it fits through what small makers like to call the slot of doom at Canada Post. And if your product can fit in a box that is this thick,
what's the measurements on that?
It's like less than 2 centimeters.
Okay.
Thick. Yeah. And it's really about the thickness, and no more than like a CD case.
Yeah.
And 30 grams is sort of the maximum that you can like send like this. So if you have small light products, you can ship things by letter mail with stamps, and it'll cost about $3 to send something like this. Just buy a few books of stamps or a roll if you're doing pretty high volume of small things like this. Put 2 stamps on it, throw it in the mailbox, call it a day. Cool. Other than buying the stamps, you don't have to contact anybody. Like, you don't have to touch anything, go to the post office. Yeah. And then for larger things, depending on what you sell, you can buy usually through your back end of your platform. You can buy shipping labels. Even through Etsy, they allow it. It's all based on weight. So you should, like, in this time, like, you should be charging for shipping if things are going outside of the city, outside of the province, because obviously, you know, it's going to take longer for things to ship. It's going to take.
And if you want to weigh things, sorry, I'm jumping in. If you want to weigh things, what do you recommend? How are you weighing? Because like 30 grams, I don't have like I have my scale for me, but like what are you measuring or what are you weighing it on?
I have a digital postal scale, it's not even a postal scale. It's a food scale and it's just digital. I don't have it with me because actually lent it to Tammy who owns Happy Thoughts and she's weighing her products for her store right now.
Little shout out to Happy Thoughts.
Exactly. So, I think I got it for less than $20 on Amazon.
Cool.
It was a deal of the day. It has saved me so many times. It's really worth it to have it because then you know whether or not you have to buy a label or you can just put a stamp on it.
Cool.
And in terms of offering free shipping, I think as makers, we're often pressured to offer free shipping because everyone's very used to it through Amazon.
Yeah.
And I would say, you know what, if your volume is quite low and you're not selling a whole lot and that is going to eat into a lot of your profits, don't offer free shipping. Maybe offer it as an incentive for people to spend more. So if you spend over $50 or you spend over $100, then free shipping is a great reward for people. And it does upsell for you as well. But if a lot of your items are small and it's going to take a lot for people to get to $100 or to get to $50, and so they're going to have to buy 4 or 5 things, maybe offering free shipping at all is not an option. You can do something like local delivery, which I know was another question we're going to talk about, where your local customers can just pick up from you or you can drop off at their house and just, you know, tuck it in a safe spot. That might be an option as well. But I don't feel like makers should have to eat the cost of shipping because our profit margins are already really low.
Yeah.
And so we still need to pay our bills too. Just like everybody else.
No, and I think it kind of leads into the next question is that right now bootstrapping is going to be more important than ever, especially because everyone's trying to navigate this new economy. It's mm-hmm. going to change indefinitely. I think we've already seen it without everything that's been going on. We're already seeing the movement of digital and how we can still keep that relationship with our customers. Now, we're not going to have a ton of money to play with, and you know, hiring someone like you to build something out is not always the option, but sometimes we just need someone like you to guide us. So if, say, you know, maybe we're in a situation we have money to put down to getting someone to build our store for us, and we have that resource, well, we know you're a great resource, people can go to you in that case. But let's say you don't have the means to build your own store. How would you suggest, like, can I do it on my own? If I was to set up my own online store, what could I do it on my own?
Yes, you totally can.
Okay.
A lot of platforms are really just as simple as following their directions. Etsy has almost no setup time at all,
right,
mostly because they control the design and the look. You just have to input the products, make a banner, call it a day. But on things like Shopify or Squarespace, they do take a little bit more work and a little more time to set up. But there are lots of really great resources directly either through Shopify or Squarespace. And I even created a live Facebook workshop. It's not live now, but it's pre-recorded now. And I've set it up through my website where people can go in and sign up for the workshop. And it normally is about $200 to take the course if you pay for it all at once. But I've set it up where you can pay in 4 payments of $55 each. So, and that's 4 payments over 2 months. So it's okay. Not 4 payments, like one payment tomorrow, one, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
You have 2 months. So you can get your store going.
Cool.
And make that money back and still be paying for it.
So I love that. So instead of them investing $2,000 or $1,500 for you to build it, you're going to actually, their investment's about $200 to actually go and get the training to help build it.
Exactly.
And I think having that local resource, I think a lot of times is like, we don't know where to go and we want someone that we can pick up the phone and call or have that connection. So deciding this while we're chatting, but we'll make sure that the link to that is in the description so that if those people that are listening to this, that it's feasible to invest in the $200 to help build your website from there, that's an option. Now, there's a lot of, like, I have questions like, how do I do this on my store? I want to offer custom products. How do I add those options? And I think we can go into a lot of detail there, but I don't want to go too deep and take away from the workshops that you are doing. But what are some things, if you were just to sit down, and the reality is some people might not have the $200 to even get that. And so today, right now, I mean, what is it, if you were to sit down, you have a product, what would you recommend? How do you set up your store? If you don't have any investment, you just know you got to put something out there. But then maybe in a couple months from now, you're starting to see some sales and you're like, hey, I know Danielle, I can take her course that's coming back in the spring if it's reoccurring. But right today, Danielle, what would be a great way for someone to just keep it simple? How do you think, what's the process from now until getting their store up? Can you walk me through that?
Yeah, it's really simple. If you decide to go with Shopify, which is the one I recommend the most, just because it's so easy to use.
But if you have more volume though, right?
It depends.
What's the cost? How much does it cost?
So Shopify, the base plan is $29 a month in US dollars.
Okay.
And that's without any additional apps. And you can definitely get away without needing any extra apps to add on that would enhance what you're trying to do. So sometimes you need one for if you want to make like a wholesale website or something like that, really fancy that you don't really need. So if you were going to do that, you create an account.
Yep.
They give you a template that you start with that everybody gets the same one. And it's really nice. I actually use it on my site because I like it. I like the way it looks and it's really easy to set up. You start when you're customizing your template, you start at the top thing, fill it out, change your colors, just go from the top thing all the way to the bottom. And once you've touched everything in that list, you're pretty much good to go. You just need to add a few products and that's it.
And now one thing that's interesting and a lot of people, And that's, I love that you say, and that's it. There's obviously a little like.
There's a lot more to it, obviously, but
it doesn't have to be.
Like, get things out there and you're not necessarily worried about being reached in search right now. You just want to get products out so that your existing customers can shop from you. That's what you can do.
That's
same
great.
If you're going to use like Etsy. You really just need to create an Etsy account, like set up the things they tell you, and they give you like a checklist. They make it so easy for you, and you add a few products. Obviously, with Etsy, the more products you add, the better you will be found in search. But at this point, that doesn't matter because you just need to be able to say to your customers, I wasn't I was supposed to be at this market this weekend. Obviously, that's canceled because we're all social distancing and trying not to, you know, get everybody sick. And so you can shop here instead.
And just preparing for the future, whether or not we don't know what's to come, but the idea, you know, when you're watching this, the idea that this is going to always be another option for people to have that access. And it's really interesting because building your store, it's really about for people to know about it. And the first part is just getting it up, but you're saying the SEO and all that stuff, just hold off. That can be part two, right? You're just saying, get it up there.
When you have time and you're not panicked anymore.
I hear you. And now another question that, you know, say you build your website or you build your platform, the biggest thing that people don't always have access to is that it's the whole other thing, the photography. Without, you know, good images, the site can look pretty bland or not professional. So I'm off the cuff, I think I'm going to do something on just teaching people how to use their cell phone and create really cool images, but we won't get into that today. But say you need to build something immediately. I know I've used Pexel and I've used Unsplash. Is there any other free copyright platforms that you use that people can get some professional images that will help build their website?
Yeah, I use
especially
Canva
if it's
all
wholesale.
The time.
Okay.
I use Canva all the time and they actually have connections with Pexels and they have their own photos. Shopify has their own copyright free photos, so you can get images. Honestly, sometimes I just Google free, royalty-free photos and it'll bring you to all kinds of resources. I do particularly like Pexels though. So
yeah. Well, there's a lot of variety and sometimes you just don't want that corporate looking, you want it to look a little unique. And I know that there's, especially more than ever, there's tons of different images that you can purchase if you want to go that route, or if they're free, there's the copyright royalty free images. So I'll write a list of these underneath. Danielle, anything else that you would like to share with people that are listening? People are going to have a lot of questions and we're kind of really touching a lot of things, but is there anything else that you feel super passionate about, you know, helping people build their website that you can give them any insight to?
Yeah, honestly, don't. I would say if you're building your website or you're trying to get online and you're trying to make sure that you're putting out the right image. I was talking about this today. It really is about getting it done right now. So having something to send people to. If you don't have any online presence or you don't have a website at all, and just getting something out there, whether it's, you know, being able to buy gift cards or something like that, so people can still support you. Get it done and then perfect it in the back end while people are still interacting. People are super forgiving of the fact that maybe you spelled a word wrong or there's a photo missing when they know that we're all struggling right now.
And it's a learning curve, especially if you've been offline for so long. And, you know, a lot of people, it's just not intuitive. Like I was chatting with my sister and I was trying to get her to do something online. And she's like, Claire, it's like cooking for you. Like, you know, you have to do it, but you don't love it. And like more than ever. So I was like, okay, well, I understand that. And I think it's a time where having people like you, having these resources are available that we can, you know, help with the conversation, help people setting these different things up, because it's more than ever, you know, allowing for people to access this stuff remotely more than ever as we're hanging out. How long have we been chatting for? I don't even know.
I have no idea.
Well, you know what? I have so many more questions, but I think this is just a really good kind of introduction to some of the things that you have insight on. You've been amazing kind of touching on a couple of things on shipping and where to go and which platforms and the cost and everything involved. So I think based on the feedback from you guys that are listening, if there's any specific questions, maybe we'll gather some questions and we'll do another episode, you know, next week, and we can kind of go a little deeper into some of the things that you guys are looking at. And as you know, Danielle's putting on a workshop that's going to be coming out, so we'll make sure we link to that. But I think more than anything, just remember, we're all navigating this together, and I think going online is going to be inevitable no matter what. And I think being able to have the resources there to set you up is so crucial at this time. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment here. I know we're going to, for those of you listening, this is audio. We're going to have this on our podcast. So we're sorry that we're talking about what we look like and our screen sharing, but we'll have it accessible for, you know, for people that prefer just to listen to the audio. Danielle, I really want to thank you for sharing this awesome information with us. It's really, really cool that you've been doing this for so many years, and this is a great opportunity now to share with our community the stuff that you've been working on. And I just want to say thanks. You are awesome.
Well, thanks for having me.
Yeah, and we'll hopefully be talking to you soon.
Yes.
Okay. Bye, guys. Bye.